Hello, my name's Tod Smith. I'm a senior technician at CDM Power. Now that we've made sure that our workspace is clear and safe to work in, we can open the enclosure and inspect the items that are vital for this thing to function properly. One of the most common things we are looking for are signs of damage from animals living in here. There's a heater that keeps the engine block warm, and that warmth attracts animals. Once they decide to move in, they often chew on wires, belts, and hoses that are important for the generator to function properly. If you see signs of animals or rodents, then it's a good reason to call for generator to be serviced. Once you've opened the enclosure, perform a visual inspection of the belts, hoses, and radiator for signs of deterioration and leaks. If there is debris located around the outside of the generator, it normally gets drawn into the radiator and causes cooling problems. Next, check out the battery for signs of corrosion. Do not attempt to clean or tighten terminals without the proper safety gear. This is generally reserved for a trained technician to perform. Note the fuel level and run hours in the generator log. Next, check the oil level like you would on your car using the dipstick. Like I mentioned, there is a heater to keep the engine block warm. The name is pretty simple. It's called a block heater. Sometimes that heater fails, so we suggest simply holding your hand near the engine block to make sure you feel the warmth of it. Once you have inspected these components, make sure the generator is in the auto mode and that the breaker is in the on or up position. Most generators have an exercise clock located in the ATS that runs the generator on a regular schedule. These test runs could be with or without building load. If you want to test run the generator manually, follow your particular site protocol. So to summarize, if you notice any of the following discrepancies, any fluid leaks, rodent damage, corroded batteries, or any active alarms, it's time to call for service.